high definition. Live, local, late breaking. This is KOLD News 13, live.
Sleep tight, don't let the bed bugs bite. There's a lot of truth to that old nursery rhyme. And this is a sight no one wants to see in their home, a bed bug infestation.
And listen to this. Local pest control companies say they are seeing more of them than ever. Here are some numbers for you tonight. These are sure to make you itch. In a recent survey of pest control companies, 99.6% of those companies had treated places for bed bugs in the last year.
Out of those surveyed, 66% say that summertime is the busiest season for bed bugs. And when it comes to the top three places where they are found, pest companies say they find them most often in apartments and condos, followed by single-family homes. And here's the scary one, also in the top three, hotels.
And tonight we are hearing from a local woman who is covered in bites after an infestation at her home. KOLD News 13's Sonu Wasu spoke with her about just how tough it can be to get rid of them. It is a story you'll see only here on KOLD News 13. Sonu?
Yeah, Heather, Dan, this is a story that'll make your skin crawl. First, let me show you what to look for. Check out this mattress box spring right here. This is what your box spring will look like if you have bed bugs. Look for the black marks. You can see this one has a few that are actually still alive, crawling around in there. And what I learned today kind of surprised me. These little pests can actually travel through your walls.
Bed bugs happen to go underneath walls and get to other people in the building. It's just an ongoing problem that we're trying to fight off. But
when you say underneath walls, what do you mean?
So they'll get underneath baseboards, underneath carpets, behind the outlet plates, and they'll actually go between the walls. They get paper thin. Thinner than a credit card.
Robert LaFrance is always on the run, just his company alone getting 5 bed bug calls a day, 100 so far this year.
If you're going to hotels, you run a high risk of bringing bed bugs back with you.
He flipped over a box spring mattress to show me the telltale signs.
We're talking about multiple apartments to big mansion houses with vaulted ceilings, assisted living homes, nursing homes, hotels, in basically any and everywhere, you know, movie theaters.
Movie theaters?
Correct, yeah, movie theaters. You bring one on your shirt and you sit down in the theater. Now the next person that comes in for that movie has a chance to bring the bed bugs along with them.
It's a little embarrassing to talk about, but I will admit I do have bed bugs in my home.
It doesn't feel good. I don't sleep well at night. At all.
These two ladies are victims of bed bug bites. The little pests feasting on their blood all night. You can see the scars.
Itchiness. Lots of itchiness. I'm scratching to where I'm cutting open the skin on my own arms.
And they're not easy to get rid of. Jody Kennedy has had her home treated twice. What type of treatments have they done?
They have done sprays.
No heat yet?
No heat yet. We've tried. We have a steam cleaner.
Heating up the home to about 140 to 160 degrees is what we do, and it eradicates them that day.
What about just spraying?
It's not as effective. You know, a lot of times what happens is you spray, the bed bugs will actually build a resistance against the chemical.
Now, we checked with the Pima County Health Department. So far this year, they have received 71 bed bug complaints. 3 of them are local hotels, 2 nursing homes, and 1 business, a local call center. The majority of these complaints are coming from local apartment complex residents. Now, we do have tips on what you need to look for and how to prevent taking one of these blood-sucking creatures into your home, posted for you on our website, TucsonNewsNow.com. Reporting live in Midtown, Sonu Wasu, KOLD News 13, live local late breaking.